giving a pseudo presentation of hypertension, for which more medicines are given, early the patient dies. I remember a lecture, I was lucky to attend a lecture on the renal failure by Dr. Mani. You may be knowing him, Dr. Mani. The creator of the chain Apollo Hospitals. Nephrologist of Mr. Jay Prakash Narayana. I was able to attend his lecture on renal failure. And since whatever bar diagram he showed, and he was himself revolving in the bar diagram like a jalebi, and finally he told one thing. He said, many times the patient is referred to me for renal transplant, not responding to any treatment given, consuming a lot of tablets in a day. I admit him, I stop all his medicine, and the patient responds very well. He was 75 when he was delivering this lecture, and in a full house of 1,000 and 1,200 plus in front of him, I was the only one who stood up and clapped on his statement and said, alas, doctor, at least at the age of 75, you understood that your tablets are killing the patient, not the patient is being killed of the disease. The unnecessary stuff you are giving him is killing the patient. The pathology of which you have not understood at all. And you said, you are a nephrologist? Should I call you that? I have to, because he was the Reverend Nephrologist of Jayaprakash Narayan. He must have many more to his credit. But this is the fact. So, other bleeding disorders. One day our principal, Dr. Joshi, as I said, when we were discussing about the Rakthapithaa, that it exists or not, he ran at 2 o'clock his lecture, he ran into the classroom, age 62. He just ran into the, man, I found Rakthapithaa exists. What is purpura? That is Rakthapithaa. I was just reading Sushruta Sanhita. And he said, yes, Rakthapithaa exists. Purpura can be taken as the Rakthapithaa. Tiryagamana. Right? So, ITP, retinal bleeds, cerebral bleeds, colonic bleeds, and where not, you name the place, it is Rakthapithaa. Then, coagulative disorders, saktam raktam. As I told you earlier, raktam saktam, urasi kanthe, as told by the charaka. But why only urasi and kanthe? Why not anywhere in the body? It is Saktam. It is Rakthapittam. So, you can treat all this. My friend's mother, he brought to me. Mother is complaining of vertigo. Doctor did that carotid Doppler and her left carotid was blocked. Since the carotid bulb up to the opening of the internal carotid, branching of the internal carotid, all the patch was blocked. So the blood supply was cut down by 25%, or rather more. And she was feeling the symptom. And then he came, hey, yaar, kya karna hai? How to tackle with this problem? It's a simple problem, man. Just 4 to 5 centimeters of block. Why are you crying so much? Give me a couple of months, I will open it. No problem with it. I started working. Her giddiness reduced day by day by day. After 2 months, I sent her for the carotid Doppler. And the doctor telephoned me. What are you doing? Oh, mai kya ki baat hai paape? Hua kya hai ye to bata? Mere ko itni yaad karke gaali kyun de raha hai? And then he said, man, the block is not there. Her carotid is open. Both the carotid patent and normal conduction rates are seen. Couple of months, sufficient time. This is what? When you read the book, and when you read the book, between the words, here every word is a sentence, and you have to read between the words. If you read between the words, you are there. Everything is possible for you. Divete, 1.5 month. That poor girl, after delivery, was given a heavy dose of progesterone for stopping the blood, and she was complaining of severe leg pain, edema, total the sural vein blocked. Mere paas aayi, I gave her the medicines and said, go. After 8 days, you start rope skipping and your pain will decrease. The pain decreased. Within 1.5 month, I sent her back to the for venous Doppler. It was clear. No problem with it. It's easy. If you see it in a different perspective. Chashma badal ke dekho. Chashma badal ke dekhoge to duniya rang rangili nazar aayegi. Change your perspective. And then you can see the picture better. So, one more. Sorry, I have not been able to bring the pictures and reports of all the patients treated because may amount somewhere around about 500 to 600 patients whose blocks, intra, extra, venous are removed. difficult to carry all the things. But some striking things I am giving you. There came a boy with a zoospermia, and vomiting the blood with a cirrhotic liver, shrunken liver. And when the Doppler was done, he was having a 15 to 17 centimeters intraportal vein block due to blood coagulation, having esophageal varices of grade 4, bleeding. And he was brought to me. I said, okay, let me tackle it. And after 7 months, I was able to remove the total portal vein block, portal vein reopening without a damage. वो भाई जब ब्लॉक निकालो बोला तो पूरी पाइप ही बदल डाली, ऐसा नहीं किया है. I have not removed the pipe. I have kept the pipe intact and removed the block. Not dealing with the patency and the structure of the pipe anywhere. This was possible with the Rakthapitta Chikitsa. The Kshara, which are mentioned there in the Charaka Sanhita, again like you, I am not going to spoon feed. Correct? I am not going to spoon feed. You have to go and read the book. I am here to open your eyes, not spoon feed you the formulas. Whatever is available to you, go get it, start working, create miracles, have an S class, no problem. So no problem with it, you can do that. Next slide please. The bleeding and clotting factors, as it was blamed when I was studying, that Ayurvedic sciences don't know the physiology, that they have not included the bleeding factors and clotting factors in their syllabus. Where are they? And this one, our reverend teacher, who always told about the shloka for the whole year. What? Dhatur dhatur prasichyate. In the last month, he changed his shloka and came to this shloka. Vaidurya mukta manigairikanam mruchanka hema malako dakanam madhu dakasyekshura sasya panam panachamam gachati rakta pittam. Can you perceive it? All the things in this shloka are the different coagulation factors. You are supplying them from outside in the form of medicine. And who the hell says that Ayurveda is not knowing the bleeding and coagulating factor? doctors. As I said, you can save a patient very nicely, and you can kill anybody without shooting him. Dangerous art. You can do right anything, and no law in the world can trace you and book you, because the lawmakers are not worthy of what this vidya is really. Correct? Next, the chikitsa chikitsa sutra of Rakthapitta is having wide applications, and its treatment is unique. See, Abhi, somebody was telling me, how is it possible to reduce all the dosages of antihypertensives in a day? No need, rather. That's what I told him. Just go on correcting the pathology. The blood pressure will drop. As it touches normal, reduce the dose half of the tablet. It will increase to some extent. Keep the treatment continuing. Again it will touch the base. Reduce the tablet. Again it will go up. One day, the patient can be totally converted on your treatment, and your treatment is to be stopped as soon as the correction in the liver done and the protein molecules restored back to their original status. So this is the plan for curing or offering a cure in hypertension, so called. For other chuchatak hypertension, like the hypertension in pregnancy, the single day uttama matra sneha pana is sufficient to cure the hypertension in pregnancy. Right? Where is it given? Who are the uttama matra sneha? Unamattah krishna mutrascha gaadha varcha sahivacha. Gulimina sarpa daushtascha. Visarpopa hatascha. And those who are sneha are garbhinyas talushoshinya. The sneha include garbhinya talushoshinya. So, this is safe medicine to employ the ghee in whatever, however may be the blood pressure of the patient. Safely give the uttam matra dose. Uttam matra. How much is the uttam matra? Don't give me textual answers. I am not going to pass you. I am not your examiner. How many ml? What is the average dose? Must be something. Madhyama matra. Very, can vary, jump up, can be reduced. No, sorry. You have not gone through the text. It appears in the It appears in the Bhava Mishra's commentary on Chakradatta. In the Udaradhyaya, he says, Ashtau palanyatra madhyama matra. Ashtau palan. Round about, you can't say, round about 350 to 380 ml. Ashtau palanyatra madhyama matra. Snehasya. Simple. It happens, but you have to read. Read and read. Never think that you have mastered the text. Even today, if I open the Charaka Sanhita, my bad luck, I can't read beyond half a page. Because it always gives me some new clues. It always gives me some new thinking. Where to copy this item and where to paste it and how to use it. And I am not able to read it totally. When I was a student in postgraduate, I was told by my seniors that, hey man, I read the Charaka for 18 times in 3 years. I said, you are great, sir. Me not able to read even a single time. But today I am able to do many more things than the guy who boasted he has read the Charaka for 18 times. My appreciation is clear. That's given in Panchatantra. Lambate yam shatadhi sahasradhishchapi eva saha ek buddhi aham priye viharami sukhe jale. Isn't it given? It took something, understood? Lambate cha shatabuddhi sahasra buddhi api eva saha ek buddhi aham priye viharami sukhe jale. Mere ko bahut jyada nahi aata. I'm not a vidwana. Just a student. All days, all new clues coming to my brain. I don't know where, how many lives I have to get to understand the Charaka Sanhita. It's really difficult. Every time you read it, it gives you a new clue. Every time you read it, gives you a new clue. And you are better, better and better. Always better. So coming, and can very easily be converted into Shonita Javikara. This is the worst idea out of that. You saw that Shonitam Tvati Dushayati in the Samprapti. And when the Shonitam is Atidushta, see, the Shonitaja Vikara can be generated. This is a specific stage in the existence of the Rakthapitta that it goes a Shonitaja. And you mean by Shonitaja? Anybody? Shonitaja? No sir, no sir. Criteria to declare a disease is Shonitaja. Shitoshna snigdha rukshadyaihi upakrantascha yegada samyak sadhya na siddhyanti. Raktajam Stan Vibhavayat. From that point onwards, they are called as Shonitaja or Raktaja. That is the absolute condition of medicine resistance. Where all the medicines given don't work, don't create any effect on the patient. And yes, this state can be reached early in Rakthapitta, because Shonitam Twati Dushayati is the basic criteria. So, that you can see in the patients. Patient says, earlier I was given one tablet, 12.5 mg. 4-5 years, the doctor said the tablet is not sufficient for you, increase the dose to 25 milligrams. 4 to 5 more years, increase the dose to 40 milligrams. Now he says, this agent is not working on you, we'll change the tablet. More tablets are added. What does it indicate? The patient is going day by day to medicine resistant state. And the doctor is not declaring him a medicine resistant hypertension. And by the time he says that it's a malignant hypertension, sir, this malignant hypertension stage is the Shonitaja Rakthapitta or the Shonitaja Avastha of the Rakthapitta. So don't think ki gulab jamun hai, koi bhi utha ke kha jayega. S class mein baithne ka sapna dekho, bura nahi hai. मगर हाल वही है कि just few months ago I got my prasad. Prasad, Volkswagen, beautiful car. You can forget S class for prasad. Drive it at the speed of 180 kilometers on Indian roads, reaching Bombay in 1 hour 10 minutes. That's all is possible. Safely. Anything can go wrong in the world, but nothing can touch you. You can hit anybody, you can hit anything in the world, anything in the world can hit you. पर अगर आपके बॉडी पे खरोच भी आई तो कंपनी पूरा पैसा वापस देगी. इट्स दैट सेफ. पर ये याद रखना कि माय फ्रेंड सेड, फ्रेंड यू आर सीमिंग टायर्ड, व्हाट इज द रीजन? से साले अंदर बैठने के लिए इतना दौड़ना पड़ता है कि अंदर बैठते हुए हुलिया खराब हो जाता है. It takes a lot of work to be done, a lot of brain work, and that is more tiring than physical work. It's easy, but out. It's a good idea. You can do that. And this medicine resistant disorders, still you can do it. Even if it's a medicine resistant or malignant hypertension, the one who can give a cure is Ayurveda. Nobody else can dream of breaking the medicine resistance. And what is the treatment? This is a fishy thing. Kuriyat chonita rogeshu raktapitta harim kriyam. In the medicine resistance, you have to operate the raktapitta harim kriyam. The treatment as narrated in the Rakthapithaa chapter. And yes, virekam upavasam cha mokshanam shonitasya cha. Sravanam shonitasya cha. Virekam upavasam cha sravanam shonitasya cha. So if it goes to malignant hypertension, upavasam first, then virekam, then sravanam shonitasya, again upavasam, and with the other treatment given, you can easily break the medicine resistance. And then one more thing to be applied that comes from the Sushruta Samhita. Once Garuda got a lot of visha inside, he drank, just consumed in liters. And when he was given the medicines were not effective on him and he was dying. And then all the Dhanvantari and other the consultants of the god, they were fumbled that even the Agada is not working on Garuda. Is he going to die? And when they asked, Vishnu told them, go to Divodasa on the earth and he will suggest you something. And they came to Divodasa and asked him why the medicines are not acting on him. What's the reason? Divodasa said, the medicines you are giving are right, but before giving it to the Garuda, close his eyes and then make him drink the medicine. It will work. And the Garuda lived out of the acute toxicity. The same way, if the oral medication route doesn't work, in the medicine resistant Rakthapithaam, you have to operate the other way. You have to give the basti. So, the treatment may not be quite simple. Never forget to do the periodical checkups of anti-CCP antibodies and ANA quantitative analysis before treating the patient of malignant hypertension, along with free T4 levels, because that is the killing idea in malignant hypertension treatment. Everything is blocked, metabolism blocked, body abruptly goes on secreting the thyroxine to increase the metabolic rate. The thyroxine, even not able to work on the body, is stored in the circulation. And if by mistake you remove the block which is blocking the medicines, the first thing to work on the body is the thyroxine in the patient, and your patient may be no more within 1 hour. So be careful. Be careful. Treating a medicine-resistant hypertension or medicine-resistant Rakthapitta, you should be patient and bold enough. Because breaking of all the antibodies, anti-CCP, anti-DXDNA, anti-RNA, it creates a lot of heat production in the body and the patient complains of intense burning. If you can't control it, he will land into acute renal failure. So be sure, be competent, be vigilant, use your brain, and you can be there. Any medicine resistant disease, you can handle. Okay? So this was for Rakthapitta and Shonitaja Rakthapitta. The Balaprapti, treatment of Rakthapitta where it ends, after the Shonita Prasadana have been achieved, after the color of the patient from tip to toe, from face to the toes, should be single tone color, no change in the color tone. Until then, you can't declare the patient to be cured. That is the Shonita Prasadana. What is the Shuddha Shonita? Prasanna Varinendriyam Indriyartha Nichantam Avyahata Paktruvegam Jitendriyam Buddhi Balopapannam Vishuddha Raktam Purusham Vadanti. Correct? Unless and until that status is achieved, your patient is not totally cured and you can't stop the treatment. Correct? At least at some level of, you may stop active treatment, but something for the Shonita Prasadana is to be consumed. And the patient asks the usual questions. How long I have to take the treatment? And my answer in the clinic is, see, you are having 5 liters of circulating blood, 2500 spare stored in your spleen, 50% buffer, great machine, 50% buffer, who works more than that? And I can filter with active treatment to a max of 400 ml per month. If nothing goes wrong, you follow everything strictly, I can filter 400 ml per month. Now you calculate how many months you have to put in. Simple? Simple chemistry. I will help you with the virechana by removing the bulk at a time. That may reduce some time, but the average time to treat will not be less than 18 months if you follow the instructions and the treatment strictly. Correct? And in case of malignant hypertension or medicine resistant state, don't ask. I am not Jyotishi. Let me work calmly. If I make any haste on your request, the effect you will be dead. Not more than that, anything. So keep quiet. May take couple of years, may take 3 years even. to break the medicine resistance and keep you alive and come out. But that's possible idea. Now I have round out more than 10-11 se to jyada ho gaya nahi Guru Bhaiya. 10 to 11 and more patients of medicine resistance totally cured from different diseases, and that can be done. Alright? So, bala prapti and varna prapti, that should be achieved. How should the patient see? Stand in front of the basin with a mirror in front of you. Keep the light source behind you. Pull your pinnas off ear. See the color of your own blood. If it is matching the normal blood spectrum color, you are cured. Simple idea. Thin layer of blood. Just double skin and a layer of flowing blood. Simplest way to observe it. You don't need a laboratory. Simple laboratory. Open eyes, you can see the color. Aage chale? Kuch hai bacha? Ha! Some comparison for you. I don't think I have to talk a lot, little about it. Just go on reading, and everything else is told. When you finish, tell me. Okay, so this is the plain point blank comparison of the two approaches. '94 mein mere paas pehli lady aayi thi. She came to me for hypertension. I said, yes, I will work. I started working. Her BP came down gradually. Day one, she registered with me, it was 180, 110. After 7 days, it was 160, 104, 5, somewhere. And gradually, it went on coming down up to 90. It was 140, 90. After 4 months, and she complained, aap kya dawa kar rahe hai, BP to badha hua hi hai. 140-90 is hypertensive, my doctor said. Alright, he may say, but what he don't explain you is that whatever medicine he gives you for hypertension starts working only when the diastolic blood pressure crosses 100. Until then, he is blindly giving you tablets. His tablets are not working on you, but rather killing you. Still you want to say? And I have gradual per week registered your blood pressure, it's coming down. Now what you want to say? You want a cure or want a tab? Then she said she wants a tab. She is not interested in cure. She wants a replacement of the tab by Ayurvedic. Then I said, do one thing, leave my clinic as soon as possible. Otherwise you will not walk out, I will kick out. I am not doing that bloody job. These guys did for 100 years. I am not going to replace you the treatment. I am not going to replace you your tablet. That's not my approach. That's not my scientific approach. If you want a cure, it's here with me. If you want a replacement, go anywhere else, not me. Haji, aapne kaha na, ki patient ko aushadh kaal mein dawa lene se problem hoti hai. Why? This is the scientific time you have to take this medicine. And why should I bend the science for you? It's you who want a cure, not the science wants you. No difference in the science whether you are alive or not. If you want a cure, this is the way for a cure and you have to follow it. Even after knowing the thing that the tablet is killing the patient, the doctor is giving the same tablet and saying that he is helpless. At least you are not helpless. You are helping the patient, and if he is not willing, you can simply kick him out. Just kick one out and nobody will complain you about the timing and dose of the medicine. Everybody coming in will be knowing it very nicely that he can be kicked out. No relaxation in the schedule. This is schedule and you have to follow. Simple idea. Alright? Next one. Last one. It has the potential to do anything with anything. You can do many things. That's all. Next one, I think it's an empty slide. Next one, that's references. And next one. Thank you. I think I finished early. So, that's something I had for you. It's a total medicine resistance, everyone. Even the Ayurvedic medicines don't work if you give. That is total medicine resistance. And you can take the patient out of that condition even. This is the wonder. I think I finished early, but these are playing with energy. They are energy pockets. They can be created, but to create them you need a lot of energy inside you, and then you can create an energy pocket. So on the rough way I told that don't do this. It's not for not possible by everybody, but can be created. Rather, you can feel the energy. If your energy level increases, then you can feel the energy. And then you can convert and play with the energy. But it's a dangerous idea to play with the energy. Don't try to play unknowingly. Because playing with the energy is not a simple job. It can hit you back as well. Yes, anything more?
Pan laga do, wahi ek aadh dukka.
There are some pictures of the retinal bleed which I covered, and they are showing it here. Akshigata Rakthapittam. This is an insulin dependent diabetic with retinal bleed. Check out the dates on which the photographs are taken. Next one. This is huge bleed. Huge bleed on this macula, huge bleed on a better bleed on this macula. Next slide. That is last slide. That is totally cured. Just before that. This is the less bleed macula, cleared. That is the scar of the bleeding, which was there, bleeding not there, reabsorbed, and now medicines are given to remove the scar so that he can see nicely. Yeah. Yeah. You see the patient walking, and there is a typical hopping walk. The patient is coming to you. Watch the patient. The walk is a hopping walk. Just his not movements are not soft. Just like this, not soft. Waiting, and he is waiting unknowingly in his walk. The pain which he feels is always somewhere here, or here. He is not complaining of pain here. Additionally, he is giving you a symptom. It's difficult for him to walk when he sits for some time and then tries to walk. Initially, there is a stiffness in the muscles which is stopping him. And this patient is not of a joint pain. This patient is of Rakthapitta. Because these all muscles which you saw, these are big muscles. Raktajaha Kandarasira. These are big muscles. Big muscles are the side product of blood. So when the Shonitam Dushayati, when the blood is disturbed, the reflection first is in the Kandara or the big muscles, and that is causing the hopping gait. Not only Siraveda, all the medicine has to be done, his liver has to be taken care, blood purified, all the
Vyayama he has to do, and the patient comes to me with a joint pain, and I give him medicines, and within a week or so I ask him to start rope skipping. Why? The rope skipping operates the peripheral hearts, as it is called, the calf muscles of your body, which helps your chest heart to improve the circulation, and as the circulation improves, the blood which is accumulated in his muscles get released and he is walking normally. You were to ask something. Yes. Yeah, yeah. Which liver? No, it's told in the liver, told in the text. And if you do a fibro scan of the liver of hypertensive, you can see the changes. You can get the fibro scan score before treatment, after treatment, and you can see the difference when you treat it textually. You can see the difference that the fibroscan score is improving. And that's what he says, that the shonita vahanam srotasam shonita bishanda guruni. You can't see a perfect block which is seen in the form of, seen on the sonography, normal sonography, because it's not a block of some permanent type, some stone. It's a transitory block or flow block. The flow has slowed down, and since it has slowed down, the compressibility of the liver with the probe, which is checked in the fibro scan, it changes. And if you treat the patient, the fibro scan score, which reflects the elasticity of the liver, it changes and it shows you that there was a block. Yes.
In start of the lecture, you was telling that Rakta is blood. Rakta is blood. I mean, start of the lecture, you told that Rakta is blood. And you said that it's made of Rasa and Rakta Dhatu.
Rasa and Rakta.
Yes. Dhatu or not Dhatu?
Rakta Dhatu is included in the Rakta. But along with the Rakta Dhatu, the Rasa Dhatu is also there. When you call blood, the liquid part of the blood is coming into the Rakta. Rasa Dhatu, and the corpuscular matter which is there, it comes under the Rakta Dhatu.
So how can we define Rakta Dhatu? This
that is there, no? ITP, when it happens, it is going into the corpuscular matter, the platelets are going down and you get the ITP. You can see different levels of marrow depression, low RBC levels in the hypertensives. And that is all the Rakta Dhatu Kshaya, as what mentioned in the Samprapti. Ah, yes, boli. Yeah. Ah. Rakta Dhara Kala has been mentioned in the texts.
Exactly, but what is the concept of it? Because it's a very confusing topic, and to apply that and understand.
Kala, just see that. Kala is a dhatvashayantara maryada. That's what is told. If you read the books in your curriculum, which are being used for more than 110 years, they will confuse you, because the writers are confused. Don't keep anything in your mind. Use it blind, or you think it blindly or blankly. Dhatva shayantara maryada. Correct? This is kala. And the mouse, when you cut, that's what the Sushruta has mentioned in the Rakta Dhara Kala. When the mausa is cut, it is seen in the mausa piercing. And that is the rakta-dharakala, the inner membrane of the capillaries and veins even. Is the place where you can say that the most inner layer of the capillaries and veins flowing in the mausa is the rakta-dharakala.
So it's only a structural component and not a functional component, sir?
Not a functional. It's a structural thing.
Okay.
That's why it has been added in the anatomy, not physiology. Yes. For excessive bleeding or DUB, that I confirm. Due to bleeding disorders or the heavy bleeding, if she has undergone hysterectomy, she is going to show you Rakthapitta symptoms, all the upadravas. The symptoms, you got the organ blocked, you got the organ removed. It was adhogarakta-pitta, was to be treated as adhogarakta-pitta and was not treated as adhogarakta-pitta. Correct? Samprapti was somewhere else in the all shonitavaya srotasa. And you removed the vyakti-sthana only. What happened? If you block, you imagine a flowing water, correct? You block it somewhere. What happens? It grows back. It grows back and it pierces laterally in all the surrounding area. The same thing happens. The samprapti is there. You have not cured the samprapti. You have just removed the outlet. And it's going to hit you. You can get this one.
Can you explain again about Svarabheda? About Svarabheda. Svarabheda.
Svarabheda. Hoarseness of voice.
No, elaborate this somehow. Means how can we see in a patient that, yes, here I have Svarabheda.
Just see the note coming out of his throat. You can hear his voice.
Mm-hmm.
And if it gets more bass, he is having Svarabheda.
So Svarabheda is showing that he is having Rakthapitta.
The bass vein increases unknowingly and the patient is not able to control. You ask him to sing,
mm-hmm.
And he will show you what is Svarabheda. He can't raise his voice easily.
Okay. And one more. Once you showed an example how a woman in the park was going like this something.
Swaying walk.
Yeah, so it is also showing that she's having Rakthapitta. It is also showing that she is having.
You just go and ask any woman walking like that if she is hypertensive or not.
Okay.
She will tell you. Simple idea. That doesn't require me.
Sir, is Shonita Ja Roga is a much more serious condition than Rakthapitta?
See, Shonita Ja Roga. There is a good long list of diseases which can go medicine resistant.
Yes.
That's a list of medicine resistant disorders or the disorders which can go into medicine resistant state.
Okay.
And that includes a lot many ideas.
Yes.
And all of them are only when they are medicine resistant, they are to be called Shonitaja. Otherwise, they are treatable by normal treatment.
Okay.
Rakta Pittam, Asrugdaraha, that you asked, Rakthapittam Asurugdara. Next is Asurugdara. Asurugdara, that's DUB, what you call. So that Asurugdara is a situation which can go medicine resistant, and that's why even in spite of giving the hormones, the bleeding is not controlled, and the doctor advises just remove the thing. But at that point, you need to intervene. No, sir, this is medicine resistance, and the medicine should be changed. If you change the medicine, break the resistance, the DUB is not going to be there. It's going to respond to the treatment. Correct?
Yes.
A long, long list. Swapna darshanam, mukhapaku, akshiragaha. This all comes in the raktaja roga. Mukha daurgandhya, asya daurgandhya, sharira daurgandhya, stavalya, what not? Everything included there. All these things can go medicine resistant. Always bear in the mind. As soon as there came a patient to me with a history of 17 years of recurrent stomatitis. Came just for stomatitis. And I gave him medicines, normal. His pachana was not going correctly. And when that was seen, I asked him to do the anti-CCP antibodies. They came positive. And then I said, for this stomatitis, I have to give you basti. Because the medicine given to you orally is not working on you. I have no other alternative rather than to give you the basti. And then he was confused. This simple thing like stomatitis, I take medicine, I get cured for a few days, again it recurs, and he is asking me to take basti for stomatitis. But no. If he wants a cure, the anti-CCP antibodies must be broken, and then only he can be cured of the stomatitis, mukhapaku.
Yes.
And this is medicine-resistant mukhapaka, for which you have to give basti. Just like that. Huh? Hypotension. Hypotension भूखा कैसे चलेगा भूखा प्यासा जैसे चलता है ना थका हुआ वो मतलब पहली नजर में तुम पता नहीं कर सकते कि हाइपोटेंसिव है या शराब पिया हुआ है ज्ञान बातु करम चालेल सॉरी थोड़ा अलग लैंग्वेज में हो गया वो कभी इधर जाए कभी उधर जाए कभी सीधा चला जाएगा कभी एकदम भाग के जाएगा कभी रुकेगा नॉट एबल टू थिंक गिरा रहेगा नॉट एबल टू अटर वर्ड्स इवन इन द सीवियर हाइपोटेंशन And there the treatment is क्या treatment होगे emergency है somebody lies walking on the road and lies in front of you on the road not able to talk irrelevant talk Not able to answer, not able to concentrate, pulse feeble, what you will do? Glucose lane tak wo behosh ho jayega. Unless and until you purchase the glucose and give him, he will faint. He will go into unconsciousness. What is the thing immediately you can do? Give him adrenaline. Give him adrenaline. And now you ask me, there is no time to give glucose and you have time to give adrenaline. The adrenaline is in his body. You have to release it. Do jhapad laga do. Immediately his body releases adrenaline, his vessels contract, his volume and all the things match, and he starts walking. Then you can give him as many things you want. Sharbat pilao, glucose pilao, sharab pilao, kuch bhi pilao. But ek jhapad marna mat bhulo. Because that is the point, you have to stop him going into unconsciousness. Any fatigue, any shock, any hypotensive attack, do one thing first, give a good hit. Ek do daat to kam se kam girne chahiye. It should be a strong blow. Because adrenaline is released by fright, flight and fight. So you can't fight with him. You can't frighten him. Just give him some adrenaline and he breathes normally. हमारे इसमें एक बंदा आता था साला जामनगर में थोड़ा सा सॉरी फॉर द इंग्लिश नोइंग वो सिगरेट पीने का रोज का बीड़ी वो और उसका ब्रोंकल कंजेशन में जाने का शैलो ब्रीदिंग उसको चार बार बोला साले तेरा बीड़ी बंद कर नहीं तो एक दिन तेरे को पकड़ के ऊपर से नीचे फेंकेगा माना नहीं रोज का बीड़ी पीने का एक दिन सुबह सुबह मेरे को कॉल आया सर ऐसा लगता है वो मरेगा शैलो ब्रीथिंग हो गई है मैंने कहा रुक जरा आता हूँ साले इतना जल्दी नहीं मरने वाला वो मेरे साथ लोगों ने मेरे बॉस को भी कॉल भेज दिया था कि पेशेंट बहुत सीरियस है शैलो टोटली शैलो ब्रीदिंग जैसे वैसे उसका सांस ट्रकिया तक जा रहा है और अंदर जा ही नहीं रहा है ऑलमोस्ट लंग कोलैप्स मैं दौड़ता हुआ पहुंचा तब तक सर भी मेरे बॉस बॉस बोले यार इसको एड्रेनालिन देनी पड़ेगी तभी ये सुधरेगा अदरवाइज ये मरा मैंने कहा क्या कहा आपने एड्रेनालिन देनी पड़ेगी एग्जैक्टली आई वॉज थिंकिंग द सेम बॉस मेरे बारे में बहुत शंकित था उसको पता था कि ये कुछ भी कर सकता है क्या करने जा रहे हो मैंने कहा कुछ नहीं आप जरा खिड़की तक जाके देखो नीचे कौन आ रहा है तब तक मैं इसको एड्रेनालिन देता हूं बॉस को खिड़की तक भेजा और जैसे ही बॉस खिड़की से नीचे झांकने लगा एक इतनी जोर से बजा दी उसकी कि एक दांत गिर गया मगर द इफेक्ट वॉज स्टनिंग एक झापड़ मारते ही उसने पूरी दम लगा के सांस अंदर खींचा एंड हिज लंग स्टार्टेड वर्किंग नो ब्रोंकोस्पैज़म इंस्टेंट एड्रेनालिन बॉस ने कहा साले मेरे को पता ही था तू मारेगा इसको बोले आप क्या करोगे मैंने कहा पेपर दे दो इधर मैं करता हूँ ना कुछ करना है मेरे को पेपर पे डिस्चार्ज फॉर बिहेवियर अगेंस्ट मेडिकल एडवाइस इंस्टेंटली ब्रदर को बोला इसको इसकी बीड़ी का बंडल और इसके कपड़े फेंको इसके ऊपर साले को दो मिनट के अंदर बाहर निकलना चाहिए हॉस्पिटल से ये बिल्कुल हॉस्पिटल में नहीं रहेगा डिस्चार्ज फॉर बिहेवियर अगेंस्ट मेडिकल एडवाइस बराबर ना नथिंग एल्स टू बी डन ये ऐसे लोगों की सीधी के बगैर वो मानते ही नहीं है नॉट टू बी एडमिटेड उसका नाम लिख के ले लो दिस पेशेंट शुड नेवर बी एडमिटेड इन दिस हॉस्पिटल वंस मोर उसको ठीक होना ही नहीं है दाल रोटी खा के साला बीड़ी पीने के लिए यहां रुकने की क्या जरूरत है मुफ्त का हॉस्पिटल है क्या यस वंस मोर हाँ हीमोफीलिया है ना रक्तपित्त ही है भैया वो श्लोक तेरे को दिखाया ना वैडूर्य मुक्ता मणिगैरी का नाम यूज इट वैडूर्य मुक्ता मणिगैरी का नाम दे आर ऑल द कोएगुलेंट्स यू हैव टू यूज यू हैव टू रिप्लेस मगर हीमोफीलिया है इसका मतलब पक्का है कि वो रक्त पित्त ही है और वो तुम जितने भी एंटी उसको कोएगुलेंट्स दोगे ब्लड रुकेगी इमीडिएटली मगर वो वापस उसी में जाने वाला है इसलिए उसको विरेक विरेचन करके पूरा पित्त बाहर निकालने की जरूरत है शोधन की अपेक्षा है और उसके बाद अगर तुम उसका वो कोएगुलेंट सारे उसको सप्लाई करते रहते हो जो भी उसके लिए जरूरत है ही इज क्योर्ड Yes.
You were mentioning about rasa, which has two types. Which one is an atvak and one is an koshta. It's about stai and astai rasa dhatu, or it's
stai rasa dhatu and koshtasta rasa dhatu. These are the two ideas.
Koshtasta means which is not undergone pachana with rasa.
It is there, uh-huh. but it works as a pool for many molecules in the circulating idea. Your circulating blood is a pool of many molecules. Some are nourishing, some are toxic, some are non-toxic, some are nourishing to the rakta dhatu, some are nourishing to the mausa dhatu, some are nourishing to the asthi dhatu, majja, shukra, everywhere. That a common pool is there and that pool is called as the koshtastha rasa and that is also included in the circulating fluid. तस्योष्मना द्रवो धातु धातोर धातो प्रसिच्यते इफ यू गिव स्नेहन सम स्नेहन एंड हीट द बॉडी यू क्रिएट द प्रोटीन्स इन द प्रोटीन एक्सचेंज इन द रक्तधारा कला मोर इजी एंड मसल ब्रेक डाउन इज अ क्वाइट इविडेंट आइडिया स्पेशली दिस ऑकर्स वेन द अतिसंतर्पणोत्थ रक्तपित्त द मैन कंज्यूमिंग मोर फैट्स इज गेटिंग द स्निग्ध स्वेद देयर द मसल प्रोटीन्स ब्रेक डाउन विद द फैट एंड दे आर being secreted into the blood or transferred into the blood along with the fat. And this is called as tasyoshmana drava dhatu dhator dhato prasichyate. When the fat liquefies, it tries to get into the blood rather than outside the vessels. Correct? And for this reason, my friends, they are opting Vidhi in the Vamana and Virechana that they start the Snehapana and they start the Bahya Sneha Sveda at the same time. This is the most worst idea in the world. Kyunki sneha pita is asvedya. Sneha pita is asvedya. That's why the sneha pita is called asvedya. You have to start the external heat and the external snehana only after you complete the snehana process. Otherwise, you are creating Rakthapitta. Correct? And in that case, the protein loss in the Virechana or the Vamana is very drastic and you feel a lot of headache side effects in the patient, and the patient takes long time to recover after his Virechana and Vamana. Where I follow the textual process, after having the 30 vegas of Virechana, the patient walks into my OPD in the evening. Sir, I am fresh. No fatigue. Because I follow the textual way. Sneha, complete. Then only Snehana Svedana outside. Then the Vamana or Virechana. Correct? So, this is the physiology behind Sneha Pitasya Svedanam. Sneha Pitasya Svedanam na karyam. He is a Svedya. Karna hai, kuch bhi padhte hai, kitab mein likha hai. Shayad tumko malum nahi, tumhari panchakarma ki kitabe likhne wale jitne bhi bade acharya, duddacharya hai na. Us sale sab ke sab जामनगर में फर्स्ट ईयर में थर्ड ईयर में एक एक गच्चा खाए हुए हैं. सब के सब, एक भी सीधा नहीं है. गच्चा तो मैं भी खाया हूं फर्स्ट ईयर में. इसलिए जैसे ही मैं फेल हो गया फर्स्ट ईयर में, तब सबने बताया, सर यू विल बी अ गुड ऑथर, यू राइट मेनी बुक्स बिकॉज दिस इज द हिस्ट्री ऑफ जामनगर इंस्टीट्यूट. Whoever gets a fail writes many books. And for that purpose I have not written a single book. I don't want to ki koi ye kahe ki sala ye bhi gachcha khaya hua hai. Right? Any more?
Sir, you were explaining the tapering dose of hypertensive medicines, how to taper the dose of hypertensive medicines,
yes,
allopathic medicines. Would you explain it once more?
What type of medication your patient is taking? In action, first study that. Samne wala kya khel raha hai ye jab tumko pata ho, tabhi tum uski taang kheench sakte ho na.
नहीं ऐसा नहीं.
पहले उसके दांव क्या है और कहां पे काम कर रहा है ये देखो. उसमें से ट्राई ये करो कि लीस्ट टॉक्सिक जो मेडिसिन है उसको कंटिन्यू करो. जो मोस्ट टॉक्सिक है उसको सबसे पहले बंद करो. नॉट वर्किंग. इफ यू वांट यू कैन स्टॉप द मेडिसिन ऑल ऑफ अ सडन इवन बिकॉज you have a potential tool of raktamokshana, volume drain off, simply drain off, volume overload simply drain off. Otherwise you have other way,
virechana,
not virechana. Virechana means some purgative, not like that. The purgatives that increase the colonic secretion, and thus they work as the purgative, not affecting the ganglia supplying the colon. You need those medicines like
Jaipala.
No, that is irritant purgative. Trivrat. One more. Tikta, not Aragvada. Aragvada is Sramsana, not Virechana. Aragvada is Sramsana, not Virechana. Kutuki. Katuki, Trivrat, then
not really, but yes, somewhat acceptable. No, not, never. If you feel instant result to be given, Haritaki doshanulomani, not virechani. It's doshanulomana.
Snuhi?
Some idea about snuhi. Yes, it is, but it's irritant. It's irritant. I can't differentiate much between snuhi and japala. Huh? Danti. Correct? Correct. Little irritant, but increasing the colonic secretion. And sabse bhayanak dawa? Indrayan. Not Indra Yava, man. Indrayana. That is the horrible medicine which is able to produce 50 ml of kashaya of Indrayana. Yes. Minimum 8 times purgation with a lot of volume drain off. Known toxin. You must be watching his heart rate every now and then when you give Indravana. Because?
Yes.
Because Schedule H medicine only to be given in front of a knowledgeable consultant, never behind him. Patient dies of cardiac inertia. Patient dies of cardiac inertia. Anything more you have?
Sir, I wanted to share a case.
Huh? Bolo.
Ki, now the patient is diagnosed as schizophrenic.
Schizophrenia? No problem.
But when I was reading these Lakshana Shonitaja Rogas, I could identify that most of the patient had most of these symptoms. And now
you never start the treatment with Shonita Prasadana.
No.
That is the problem of psychiatrists.
Yes.
Because they are themselves psychiatrists.
And
yes, you can do that.
Yes.
You can give the Tiyushna Virechana, you can give the Snehana, Pachana, Basti, even if you want, and you can get the patient out of schizophrenia even. Rakta Mokshan always, always prefer. At the Shankha Pradesha, keep one Jaloka, patient starts talking normally. Sravanam Shonitasya Chya. This Chya is a very, very critical word in Charak Samhita. If you understand the Chya in the Charak Samhita, you are the masters. If you don't know the meaning of the Charak Samhita, Chya in the Charak Samhita, you are nothing in the world. Because this person has not at randomly added cha to any word. The all words which he has added cha are special. So always give it 1,000 considerations more before interpreting. This cha is? Anybody doing MD in Sanhita or something like that? What is cha? In which year you are studying? Second year. Which college? Hassan. Achcha. Wo Girish ke paas ho. Achcha.
This charak, cha in the charaka sanhita represents the brahmana vashishtha nyaya. This cha in the charaka sanhita represents the brahmana vashishtha nyaya. Now don't ask what is brahmana vashishtha. Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadya takram tu vashishtebhyo. This is the classical description. This comes in the Mahabharata. Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadya takram tu vashishtebhyo. What does it mean? What you understand out of that?
We should prioritize.
Yes, the priority change. The consideration change, the orientation must change as soon as you attach the word cha to anything. Even if written like the swarabheda, swarabhedas cha. That cha means that is number one. Though written at the end, it is to be taken as number one. That is brahmana vashishta. So what you understand? By the explanation, Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadyat takram tu vashishtebhyo. Vashishta is also a Brahmin. When you call Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadyat, Vashishta is also included. Then, why you say takram tu vashishtebhyo? Because though he is a Brahman, he is separate, he is different, he is special. That's why takram tu vashishtebhyo. Vashishta ko takra hi dena hai, Brahman ko dadhi de do. Correct? This is the meaning of cha. And this is to be applied everywhere the cha is added. This is a simple thing, or rather a method to read and understand the Sanhitas.
Sir, then is it the Buddhe Sammoha that explained in this?
Buddhe Sammoha is what you call as schizophrenia, ma'am.
Sir, then how do we differentiate, like whether it is Unmada or?
रक्त शुद्धि का चिकित्सा चालू करो. रक्त शुद्धि का चिकित्सा चालू करने के बाद अगर बुद्धे सम्मोह कम नहीं होता है तो
उन्माद
स्टिल डेंजरस आइडिया. देन थिंक ऑफ डिप्रेशन. Katham ashmalam idam. Got it? Gandhi vam sramsate karat karke Arjun baith gaya. To prahasanyava bhagavant ne katha. Katham ashmalam idam tvam parigatam. Pahle usko do laate maro. Ki sale kya kar raha? Wahi bhagavan ne kiya. Has diye? ऐसा ले इतना नहीं आता तेरे को क्या. दस पंद्रह लोग सामने देखे नहीं तो तू हाथ छोड़ के गांडी छोड़ के बैठ गया. क्या मतलब है तेरे होने का? ऐसे ही चालू किया ना. प्रबोधन करो. एंड इवन आफ्टर दैट ही इज नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग करेक्टली डू गो फॉर शोधना. Do go for Shodhan.
Thank you, sir.
Stepwise approach that will pay you in the clinic. Clear understanding which is to be there. Otherwise you make a mess. Otherwise you make a mess. So, शास्त्रम ज्योति प्रकाशार्थम दर्शनम बुद्धिरात्मना. दर्शनम बुद्धि दर्शनम आत्मना.
enlighten yourself first, then you can rogansh chikitsati. Otherwise, nasa rogansh chikitsati.
Sir, ye jo sequence bataye, iska bhi koi importance hai kya?
Ye sequence to maine tumko kuch point bataye hai, pura protocol nahi bataya.
नहीं सर जी ये जो लक्षण जो बताए जैसे मुख पाक अक्षिराग पूति घ्राणास्य गंधत
वो तो है तभी तो बताया है बट इट्स अ लॉन्ग लिस्ट सो कांट प्रेडिक्ट इसके बाद ये क्यों दिया इसके बाद ये काम ये करेंगी ना ये कुछ नहीं करती है बैठ गए ऐसा क्यों है वैसा क्यों है इसके जवाब इनको पूछना बट एनीथिंग एल्स What are? Means you want? Emergency treatment you mean for bleeding? To stop the bleeding a list of medicines is given. If not working, then pratimargam charayam raktapittam vidhiyate. If he is vomiting blood, induce purgation. If the DUB is there, you want to stop? Induce vamana. Not 6 to 7 vamana are not needed. Just a couple of vamana, the DUB stops. That's it. For bleeding. For coagulating disorders. I told you kshara. Kshara in the form of lepana. Kshara in the form of pana, kshara in the form of basti, anything you can do. All these are emergency treatments. And if you are ready, prepare the medicine in injectable form, dilute with 1 cc, 2 cc distilled water, give intravenously. In the nearest part where the block is, you can see. Block in the artery, spot the block, enter the vein, nearest vein, just inject, the block will be.
Pancreas.
What? What
pancreas?
Pancreas.
Close.
How you came to know?
2015, I had to make the pancreas passage.
Okay.
And right now, last 3 months, continuously checking. I have lost weight up to 15 kgs. So I have checked, and now sugar is 250.
You feel the heaviness in the body?
No.
When you get up in the morning?
Yeah, no, 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 not like that. No symptoms are getting
there. Okay.
Only weight loss.
Burning sensation, pain after taking food.
Yeah, body sometimes when I take food after 1 or 2 hours.
Yeah.
It's having even most of night time. Burning sensation.
6 to 7 times a day bowel movements.
Yes.
You must oily substance in the bowel.
No sir, morning 2 times is normal.
Okay.
After that it's like that, green like that.
Okay.
Oil
in this then. Okay. Habits. Vishamasana is there. Vishamasana. Rakthapithaa. That has not been mentioned. your tongue. Do you feel some hoarseness in your voice? In the body sometimes. For some time it persists and it goes on its own.
No, monthly once or twice.
Monthly once. But do you have to take some medicine from that?
No. But on the stomach, the stomach pain?
Yeah. Is it pending here? When I do this? Here? Here? Right. Here?
Thank you.
This is a case of alcohol
intake and that tobacco intake since long, and it has deranged his hepatic function as good as his splenic function. All the metabolism is on the lower side, indigestion is there, and that is paying him in the terms of gulma in the pain in stomach, and which comes once a month, twice a month, and he has to take the painkillers for that. But he is showing the symptoms like Bhukte Godo Vidaha, he is complaining. He is showing other symptoms of the hepatic degeneration and derangement. He is having some shrotha on his legs, blackishness, Shonita Dushti, which problems of Shonita Dushti is in him, and he is giving the other symptoms like Akshimalinya, Swarabhera, which is very peculiar, he is telling. Angushtapoda Shula is there, but he is complaining of the Kandara Shula. Padarauksha Karshni is there, and the Jiva is Nipta, telling that he is in the Samavastha.
Is it clear? Any more doubts?
Thank you.
Any questions to be clarified out? Can you please be a little louder, please?
Yeah. We have to give only Pachana or Pachana Deepana for how much days?
We have to give only Pachana or Deepana Pachana, and for how many days?
In the initial stages, when you are going to deal with the doshas, unless and until the doshas are there, Pachana is the first thing to be done, because you can't remove the apakva doshas from the body. And for that purpose, you have to stimulate the metabolism so that you can get the doshas out as much as possible. And for that, initially some Pachana is to be given. Here the patient is awake, conscious, and all other things are okay. So you can give him Pachana, and then you can give Uttam Matra. In the case of severe emergencies where the toxicity is of severe nature, you can't wait for the Pachana, and you have to directly give the Uttam Matra Sneha, and that works.
After Uttama Sneha, we have to give
duration,
or we have to give Pachana?
No, not directly. Uttama Matra Sneha will detoxify him. After that, we have to go on with the Pachana at the Dantu level, Rakta Pachana, Rasa Pachana, then Mamsa Pachana. All these things are to be achieved. And when the Pachana in the lower level or the Dantu level is completed, then we can go for virechana with appropriate sneha. And the official choice here will be panchagavya vrita for abhyantara sneha, since it is a clear case of toxic hepatic degeneration.
How much? For 7 days, for 14, how long?
What for how long? Can you please repeat?
This Pachana after Uttama Snehana, for how long it should be given?
Snehana for how long to be given?
Snehana, that is when you start the Virechana. We all follow the general process of Snehana with increasing doses in 5 days, gradually increasing the dose from 50 ml to 200 ml, and if the samyak snigdha lakshana, they are not seen, Then we increase the dose, repeat it once again at 200 ml for 1 or 2 days.
Pachana, for how long it should be given?
Pachana, how long? That's not an answerable question, because as the patient responds, early, you can give it in 7 days or at least 21 days will be needed with good pachana to reach at that dhatu devala.
How can you understand if it is proper pachana or not?
Yeah, we can see that from the questioning, the srutu dushti lakshanani and the sama dhatu lakshanani, they are given in the text. We can assure from that the dhatu gata pachana is done, and then we can give the vivechana.
Hello?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes. Hello?
Yeah, please.
Yeah.
Correcting
Panchagavya Vritam.
Reason for selecting
Panchagavya Vritam. Panchagavya Vritam is the only thing which is having antitoxic properties. It's the best thing which is given in Ayurvedic texts. In the Unamata Chikitsa, and his total directive is for antitoxic. Yeah, the tobacco toxicity and the liquor toxicity, while all we have to get rid of. For that, the Panchagavya is chosen. Night increased. Okay. That is after the coughing, but not earlier it was.
After the coughing.
What color of sputum you pass?
Complaining of non-productive cough since 10 days. But now I'm asking, he said it is in mild forms and severe since 10 days and it's there since 1 month. He's also having breathing difficulties, which is recently aggravated 3 to 4 days. He's having more cough when he's having food. That is one of the main complaints. He also feels nauseous and burning sensation in abdomen, and he gets more of burps. When he gets phlegm, it's more of yellowish sputum, mild yellowish sputum. And he's also complaining of back pain, whole back pain, from neck to low back. Yeah, these are the presenting complaints that the patient has said. Any questions? Please hold on. I shall ask. Yes, any questions? Is the case clear?
Sleep pattern.
Sorry?
Sleep
pattern.
Are you able to sleep or the cough is there in the night? Enigma and that is giving him the night cough. which is dominant in him, but he is having no samatha, as his tongue is totally clear, and he is having a low grade infection of mostly staphs, cocci, maybe some rods may be there. It's from the Pitta Bhanishti Vanam, we can deduct it, and simple seasonal coughing and Sharadiya Jwara, we have to treat Vaitika Jwara with Kasa.
Any questions? Any points? Any diagnosis? Differential diagnosis, I would say.
Madam, any tuberculosis?
No history of tuberculosis. It's just recently that he's having such severe cold and
This is Thaviras Kasa. But he is not that old to call it a Jara Kasa. It is Thaviras Kasa and associated with Vaitika Jwara, which is a Sukha Satya idea, as the Vaitika Jwara and the Insharada. So it's a better idea to treat him with the medicines, least digestion needed, just some Virechana, some gargling, and a little bit of calming agent in the Vyana and Udana, like Guruji Sattva and the Vidruma Pishti, will suffice. Just lie down. Just check for some any problems. Yakrita Nada are not Ghana. So the Liha is not also Ghana. The Atmana of a certain degree is definitely there with the abdomen tight. And so he is having Malashuddhi, passing the stools for two times in a day, and that indicates that the Malashuddhi is not there, and that's what we have to give at the most of some Anudomana and some Mrudu Virechana. Thank you.
Any other doubts or questions to be cleared out?
Please read out the treatment so that they can have any interaction in terms of questions.
Sir has prescribed the medicines. Morning 6 a.m. Mahasudarshan Ganvati. 10 a.m. Draksharishtam, 2 spoons. Patola Katarohani Adhikashayam, 2 spoons and Vyana and Dana. Gokshuradi Gugulu, 2 and 6 p.m. 2 tablets with water. Ratro Apana Avipattika Churna, 1 spoon. With Sir Draksha.
Draksha Panaka
or Sharbat? With Draksha Panaka, Agastya plus Madhu, 5 to 6 times a day. This is the medicines that sir has prescribed. Any questions or doubts, please? If no, shall we proceed on? Yes, sir.
Agastya Rasayana with what?
With honey. Mixed with honey and is to be laid varam varam or more more. It will be required for a couple of days only, but as his age is 60 and above, we have to keep these lungs strengthened, and that is possible with the Agastya Rasayana, which is Sandhanagara properties, and that's why it's given.
But the honey is Usna property.
No, honey is Tikshna, but not Usna. Honey is Tikshna, but it's Sita.
Shall we move on? Any more? So shall we? Medicine is to put on the answer to the father. Medicine is the answer. Along with the case of the good father.
Since the patient was having no samatha, and that we had been able to proceed directly to Mrudu Vivechana in the form of Avibhaktikara. But the Avibhaktikara they prepare here, they use the dalchini in a higher dose. So I am mixing it with the Raksha Rasa. So to make it Mrudu. And Raksha is also Jeevaniya, so it will help him in healing the lung irritation. Can you walk?
அந்த ஃபேன் கிட்ட இருந்து இந்த வரைக்கும் வாங்கும்
dragging the right leg in a circumduction manner to give her some swaying in the walking, and that is the hypertensive walk. She is non-hypertensive. Blood pressure is 180-100 as taken right now, and she is complaining.
What are you? She is complaining of giddiness and then she is telling she is hypertensive and she takes medicine in the morning after.
Which medicine you take?
In the matra irukumenga per theriyuma matra. She doesn't know the names. வேற என்ன பிரச்சனை இருக்குங்க?
அது கால் வலிக்குது.
கால் எங்க வலிக்குது?
கால் கேள் வந்துட்டு
சார். So she's complaining of knee pain and ankle joint below knees.
Yes.
Leg pain.
Where does it pain in the knee?
காட்டுங்க. முட்டில எங்க வலிக்குது? பாருங்க. முட்டில எங்க வலிக்குது? காட்டுங்க. முட்டில எங்க வலிக்குது? பாருங்க.
You can see where she is touching for the pain side. She is not touching the bones, she is touching the sides of her knee. That clearly indicates that that is not a joint pain, that is a Kandala Shuddha that I was calling you. That she is complaining of the Kandala Shuddha. You can just press the Kandala and see how she cries. Yes?
Balikida amma? Yes sir, she is having pain there. She is having pain there.
Yes, she is having pain on when you press the kandara, and that confirms that the stambha is in the kandara. She is having the pada sutra of lower grade. Here you pain? Yes, she is complaining of the pain in the parsini. And Parshni Parshva, which is also a site of Kandala, and she is having a lot of pain when I press. You move your leg.
Mutti, mutti, irukka amma. Ipadi. Sir, she's right. வலிக்குதா ரொம்ப ஜாஸ்தியாக வலிக்குதா
கொஞ்சமா
நடக்கும்போது வலி ஜாஸ்தியாக இல்லை கம்மியாக ஷீ ஹேஸ் மோர் பெயின் வென் ஷீ இஸ் வாக்கிங் அண்ட் இட்ஸ் பெயின்ஃபுல்
தி ரௌஷ அண்ட் தி ஜானு ப்ரோஷ்டி ஷூத இஸ் மோர் ப்ரோஃபார்ம் தேர் இஸ் ரெபிடேஷன் இன் தி மூமென்ட் ஆஃப் ஹர் நீஸ் which is clearly indicating the Raksha and the coming Astiksha in her. We will see the Nadi, Jiva, Shumita.
Now cut, now need to.
Little, very little lift the tongue. You chew that palm.
Yes, sir, she
is. Is it with tobacco?
No. Any questions from students? Anything that you want to clarify? Any preferable diagnosis? Any differential diagnosis that you want to discuss?
Since how long she is hypertensive?
Evlo naala pressure maatra saapringa
amma. Rendu rendu varsha saapringa.
Pressure edukku ungalku eppa therinjathu?
Sir,
she had a history of a fall and she was taken to hospital. Then only she realized that she is hypertensive. And it's 2 years that she's taking medicines.
Could one prachodita feel angry, ugly?
Vegama will go home, Verma. Yes, yes, sir.
Feeling the salty taste in the mouth?
Now, if you may poop, the Mari taste Verma will go home, Madri Nala. அல்ல வாயில எப்பவும் அந்த மாதிரி உப்பு டேஸ்ட் மாதிரி காலையில காலையில நோ சார் டசன்ட் கம்
ஃபீல் ஸ்மெல் பேட் ஸ்மெல் இன் தி ப்ரீத்
வாயில ரொம்ப ஸ்மெல்லா இருக்குமா நல்லா இல்ல மூஞ்சில ரொம்ப கெட்ட ஸ்மெல்
வருது
இல்ல வாயில கெட்ட ஸ்மெல்
வருது பிஃபோர் பிரஷிங் பிஃபோர் பிரஷிங்
எந்திரிச்ச உடனே பல்லு விளக்கிறதுக்கு முன்னாடி
Okay.
So she's saying as she puts tambul, she is not able to.
Body pain, heaviness.
உடம்பு ரொம்ப வலிக்குமா ரொம்ப பாரமா இருக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்குமா
உங்களுக்கு
மொத்தமா வலிக்குமா பாரமா இருக்கு Very, very painful. Throughout the body, it's very painful. And she feels very difficult with movements. Yes, please. Please ask.
Can she sing or like raise her voice?
Can she?
Sing.
Sing?
Yeah.
Her voice, just talk something so that you can perceive the voice. Not singing is required always.
உங்களுக்கு என்னென்ன பிரச்சனை இருக்குன்னு மொத்தமா
சொல்லுங்க ஒரு பிரச்சனை எனக்கு ஒர்க்கு வலிங்க கால் வலிங்க
அப்புறம்
பெருசு
எவ்வளோ நாளாக
பெருசு ரெண்டு வருஷம் சாப்பிட்டுருக்குங்க அது வந்து இப்போ தண்ணியில இருக்கிறதுக்கு ஒரு காரணம் கால் வலி வலிங்க
She was just explaining her whole complaints. Was it sufficient? So she also said one point that she works more in water or in cold thing, it aggravates her pain very badly. She keeps on walking throughout the day, so that is also very difficult for her. Any more questions?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Why can't we take it as Mamsakatha Vata?
Why can't we take it as Mamsakatha Vata?
Mamsakatha Vata. Mamsagata Vata is Danta Mushti Hatam Shudha and which is relieved when you press. Here if you press the Shudha is increased and that distinctly differentiates that when you press, the shoulder is not relieved, yet the Kandara shoulder is increased on pressure. And Mausagata Vata, the weakness and other symptoms, Gauravan is very profound, the movements are very stambhayukta, and that much stambha is not perceived here. She is able to move, she is able to walk. The Mausagata Vata patient is not able to walk that easily. And that is mostly in the latter stages diagnosed as the myasthenia. And these are the symptoms of Mausagata Vata. They are telling. I already have two cases of Mausagata Vata diagnosed as myasthenia gravis. They have responded well on that treatment. But this is typical Rakthapitta, and Rakthapitta just number.
Going towards the more resonant side, and that indicates that
That is an apatarpana chadushti due to which the srotasas inside have gone hollow or are in the apatarpana state.
Thank you. One more question. If I am not, for example, that knowledgeable as your sir, and I'm just given a diagnosis that it's just Rakthapithaa, it will help or it will not?
Rakthapithaa is the diagnosis, but the present condition of her is going towards the apatarpana due to the less consumption of sneha.
Okay, okay.
How many spoons of ghee you take per day?
No, sir, she doesn't.
She is not taking any amount of sneha inside. That is the cause of those resonant nodes on her spleen and liver.
Thayir irupingla? Thayir, thayir.
Madhyana irukingla, night?
Kaal
illaya. Tiffin kudaya? Tiffin kuda.
She takes curd in the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
The curd is Brahmana, but it is Ruksha. Dadhi Ruksha, though it is Brahmana. Let us see your pulse. You feel energetic when you get up in the morning?
காலையில எழுந்திருக்கும்போது நல்லா fresh energy இருக்குமா உங்களுக்கு நல்லா இல்ல ரொம்ப இதா சுஸ்தா
இருக்கு?
காலையில எழுந்திருக்கும்போது இல்ல she wakes up with pain and weakness.
I think this must be going around from 4 to 5 years.
In the pain sir, the body?
No. Unhealthiness feeling in the morning when she gets up.
இந்த மாதிரி காலையில எழுந்திக்கும்போது உங்களுக்கு ரொம்ப இந்த மாதிரி முடியாம ஃபீல் பண்றது எவ்வளவு நாளா இருக்கீங்க?
2 years.
She is saying of 2 years must be earlier than that because this is Jirnajvarodha Rakthapithaa Apatarpana Javastha. This is a thing which is to be treated on the lines of the Jirnachvara first and then you can get her Rakthapithaa corrected. If her Jvara corrects, her Rakthapithaa also gets corrected. She is not that bad idea. kashaya get amrut roar. Here we have given the treatment. We start with the treatment of the Jiranajwara. The Samatha is not very much, but it is to be considered as she is complaining of the symptoms of the Jwara. We are starting with the Mahasadarsana or Ganavati, lest we won't get, that is Trishuna, for 5 to 7 days. After that, we go for the treatment of Jiranajwara with one tablet of Lagumalini Vasanta with warm water at 10 o'clock to clear the inside dosha in the spleen. We give a little clearing agent like Rohitarishta, 1 spoon only, and at 2 o'clock and 6 o'clock we give the Gokshadashi Gokuli. But here this patient is going towards Apatarpana, so rather than using Gokshadaji Gokula, we use here the Gokshadachivarna with the Trinabanchamula Kashaya, so that the Apatarpana is not increased due to the treatment, balancing it. Then in the night Apana, we are using the Alpantika in the low dose, because she is showing Apatarpana treatment, we can't induce the Virechana, though it is indicated in the treatment of the Jiranajwara, and so we keep the dose low and achieve the treatment, and specifically to see that the doshas in the Rakta and Rasa go, we are giving Amritottara Kashayam in the Vyanakala, but to support it, not to cause Atyapatarpana. We are supporting it with Guruji Sattva at Vyana and Udana Kala. And the compulsory intake of ghee, 6 to 8 spoons per day is advised, so that she doesn't go into Apatarpana and recovers. Amritottara Kashayam is the Kashayam of preference in the Jiranajwara. And to concentrate its activity in the lower dose we are prescribing, we are giving it in the Vyana Kala, so that its activity is targeted to the blood and Rasa and Rakta Dhatu, where the Samatha a little is lying.
Any more doubts?
How do we diagnose this patient's Jiranajwara?
The symptoms she is showing The morning anutsaha, kshunamandya and all the picture of Raksha, Kandara Shula, but rather than the Kandara Shula, she is showing the Daubalya, which is very peculiar, and Stamba is there, and Pidana Sattva, and she is going towards Apatarpana. So, rather than taking her directly into the Apatarpana, the Rakthapitta, and starting bigger treatment, we have to start from, as I mentioned in the lecture, that the Jvarasantapa Rakthapitta Mudiriyate. So this is the condition where the Jvarasantapa, she is going towards Rakthapitta, and that is of the Apatarpana kind, because she is not taking ghee. If her Jvara is treated with adequate ghee and followed by Virechana, her hypertension will disappear.
Any more doubts? Shall we proceed? We'll move on to the next case.
So I could pain. Neck. Left knee joint. Repeated cold, breathing difficulty, strain to pass through, vibandha, malashuddhi, burning sensation in abdomen, udara daha, very there. Hysterectomy. For what the hysterectomy was done?
Saying she had a mass in the uterus, that is why she had to remove, and excessive bleeding when she used to have periods.
That is the combined picture of Artha Vasrata Madhudavartha with a bit of Rakthapitta type symptoms, for which she has undergone hysterectomy, and now have you gained weight after the operation?
The operation பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் weight ரொம்ப ஏறிச்சா ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ஆச்சு உங்களுக்கு இப்போ கர்ப்ப பையடிங்க யா அந்த ஆபரேஷன் பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் weight ஏறிச்சா
வே எவ்வளவு ரொம்ப தப்பா ஏறிச்சா இல்ல
கொஞ்சம் she has weight not drastically but she has gained weight
is the short on the face in profound in the morning
இந்த மாதிரி உங்களுக்கு ஃபேஸ்ல வர அந்த வீக்கம் காலையில ஜாஸ்தியா இருக்குமா இல்ல எப்பவுமே இந்த மாதிரி
எப்பவுமே
இந்த மாதிரி வீக்கமா தான் இருக்கும் கொஞ்சம் எடையில தான் தண்ணி குறை ஆகும் ஓகே she always has this edema specifically when she works more with the water associated then it increases then she'll have more of headache and
body
ache உடம்பெல்லாம் வலிக்குமா உங்களுக்கு She feels more in overall the body and cramps in arms.
Cramps in arms. This is all a typical picture. As we are discussing after hysterectomy, the symptoms increase, the shodha increases, and this is the case of shodha increases. You can observe her walking even while she goes out. We will put the camera on her. You can see the sway. When she walks afterwards, first we will check the nadi. Should be done.
Naak katuma, naak.
Vele, full of
it. How many times you have to pass the urine?
Mutra.
Where in the night?
Mutra.
Evlo vati po.
Evlo vati. Night evlo vati po. Night po ingla. 2 to 3 times
in the night. See, the shodha is going up. Is she consuming any tablet for hypertension?
Pressure the matra is going to be like more.
ப்ரெஷர் இருக்கு
ப்ளட் ப்ரெஷர் இல்ல நோ சார் ஷீ இஸ் நாட் டேக்கிங் எனி மெடிசன்
யூ கேன் டேக் ஹர் ப்ளட் ப்ரெஷர்
Patient basically complained of cervical pain since 5 months. She also gave the history of fall and left knee joint, which is aggravated more, and recurrent cold and cough with breathing difficulty. She's also complaining of strain to pass stools with constipation and burning sensation and abdomen.
Guru Tom, body heaviness. Heaviness in the body.
Or mala romba weight a irukra mari romba bharama irukra mari.
Can you put the camera?
Sir,
can you put it on her nose? Typically she is showing the tip of the nose swollen.
She feels very heavy overall in the body, sir, and when she walks she feels difficulty to breathe.
You can see it on your screen. This is a typical swelling on the nose, which is many times seen in the Rakthapithaa, and as Kashi complains, the night frequency of urine has increased. There is always a way to check her blood sugar, and it must be going high. If not the blood sugar is still too high, she is going towards prameha, that is a certain idea.
Guys.
See her hands, the knuckle blackishness is there. Overall blackishness, it's all there, lips, ears are also getting black. There is Guruta in the Nadi.
Any questions, please? Any points to ask? Any conclusions?
எவ்வளோ நாளாக இந்த மாதிரி பழக்கம் இருக்கும் உங்களுக்கு?
Yes, as you asked, she takes morning empty stomach, she takes around 2 to 3 glasses of water, and it's a habit from past 7 to 8 months.
Clear the bowel?
She feels thirsty, sir.
Is there some stickiness in the mouth?
If she doesn't drink water, then feels, then she feels sticky. No, sir, no, no.
She has not observed mostly. She will be showing. Show your teeth.
Now will you?
Hastapanitalo Dana? No. Burning in the hand and foot?
Towards the heel area and soles.
मीठा मीठा होता है also showing the Kandara Shodhi which we talked about. Clear? See, and I press the bones in the knee, she is not complaining of pain, but the pain is more on the Kandara. Is that profound? Just press hard and she cries. Just hold the legs. There is Radhavana. When I press?
No, no pain, sir.
Here? Here? Here in the etiology of the nidana of Rakthapitta, you see that it repeats as it is in the in the nidana of the prameha, all the three of them. So after Rakthapitta, if in a condition like this the shodha increases and the mother medha abaddhata goes, there is always a chance for the patient as it is to go into the diabetes, or if the rakta dushti is more profound like this patient, it's always a chance to go into madhumeha. The madhumeha and prameha, they both are separate entities described separately in the text, not related, but prameha in the latter stages can be converted into madhumeha as they have said. But the madhumeha can exist specifically without prameha, and that is seen here. How much is it?
138.
So, little guruka up in the nadi is perceived, and that gives her some upper tone in the blood pressure. Of course, it's afternoon, so we can't draw any perfect conclusion from that. But in the morning, if we check the BP, it will be more easy to diagnose. But the shodha and the other all symptoms, they are all indicating towards one point, that udavarta with Rakthapitta, which was earlier there, and now it is going showing all the symptoms of the Rakthapitta, and it's to be treated, and not the least her blood sugar and HbA1c, rather than sugar, HbA1c is to be critically monitored and corrected.
Any questions? All clear? Ma'am?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, the walking style?
Yeah. So shall I ask her to walk? They are asking the walking style.
Yeah, she can.
Camera article, not a camera. அம்மா இருந்துட்டு அந்த பக்கத்துலேருந்து இந்த பக்கம் வரைக்கும் கொஞ்சம் நடந்து பார்த்தீங்களா? மெதுவா நடங்க, இந்த பக்கம் வரைக்கும் நடங்க. நீங்க யூஸ்வலா நடக்கிற மாதிரி நடந்துருங்க, எதுவும் பார்க்க வேண்டாம்.
Can you see that? The way she walks, maybe looking at many people walking like this nearby you, always dream of pehle pair dekho kitne sujhe hue hai, phir chehra dekho kitna sujha hua hai, kaala pan dekho, aur sabse pehle naak dekho. If the nose is swollen, Always keep it in mind that the Rakta Dushti is there, and the patient may go towards the Madhumeha very fast. So always keep a watch and treat accordingly. Any questions?
Ma'am, excuse me.
Yes, please.
The question is to sir, when someone is walking like this, it means that he's having prameha, or it means that he's having rakthapitta, or how to differentiate?
The The walking pattern is more profound in the Rakthapithaa. But if he is going towards Pramaya, that you have to see from his face, his overall bulk, and as I said, see the nose of the patient. If it goes up swelling, it is directly proportional to his Rakthapushti and it's dragging towards the Madhumeha due to the reduction or the increase in the HbA1c levels beyond 7 and 8.
So if nose is swollen, then it is a characteristic feature.
Yeah, definitely. You have to check out the Shaithilya of the Mausa, and for that, Shaithilya of the Mausa is to be checked in the Kandara. In these cases, you can't do that because the Kandara are in Stambha. So you have to check the muscles of the arm or the neck. Here you can see the Shaithilya. So just put your arm behind the neck and try to pull and press, and you will see the tone of the muscle. If it is gone, your patient is going towards diabetes, that is sure.
No, sir. I've seen a case like Nasa Shaithilya. The patient is complaining like that whenever she is feels weakness, she said that the nose feels like soft, ball like that.
Yeah, definitely. The same thing, sir. If it increases, the shodha increases, it increases with the sugar, and as it increases with the sugar, the Shaithilya is always going to be there. And if the Shaithilya, she is complaining, her HbA1c must be in the level around about 11 or 12 or beyond that.
Any more questions?
The Atmana which you are perceiving in this patient and the earlier lady even is very difficult to compete with the Atmana and the Udara Gaurava and Anga Gaurava. They walk like that. The walking pattern is very difficult, but the cause of it is due to the physical debility and the symptoms.
Any questions,
anyone? Not sleeping now.
No more questions.
Fibroids, but how you look at the fibroids is more important. That indicates the udavarta in that srotasa. So that udavarta, where the apana vayu whirls, it tends to turn the muscles in the uterus into balls. And that you call fibroids. The bleeding is usually associated with the fibroids because the udavarta never takes place one on its own. If it's one on its own, it may not be converted into fibroids. But if it goes on converting into fibroids, it produces the hit back on the metabolism, causing
The rasa samata then implicates into the rakta samata and the blood getting impure, and then the bleeding starts. So this is the point. If the patient lucky enough to come to you at that stage, it can be managed with the rakta samata and the rasa samata treatment, and just some brushing of the fibroids by medicine can take care of all the things. But since she has already undergone hysterectomy, now you just can guess what was the cause of what. And she is saying symptoms of the shonita dushti, as I showed you, the kandara shulam, the karshnya, the rauksha, and the typical part, the rakta is more associated with the heel area or the parshni. So the parshni shula, and if some sort of shotha round about the parshni is there, always think of the rakta and the rakta dushti. And if the shotha is there, always ask or keep in mind the rakta pitta. Not always in the initial stages. That's why a study in US was conducted with 20,000 cases post hysterectomy history, and they have noted that in the cases where the uterus was removed due to the excessive bleeding, the onset of post hysterectomy complications was the most, while in other cases it was as long as 10 to 15 years and even more than 15 years, as the study revealed. So not always, but if the hysterectomy is done for the excessive bleeding or the DOB as they call it, then it's sure that the patient was having rakta pitta and the organ was removed rather than treatment, and the samprapti is still there and he is going to show the complications. That's why I diagnose these people, these ladies, as tachanasti sachasti ruk. The organ is not there, but the ruk or the samprapti is there. Tachanasti sachasti ruk. The opposite has been told by the Sushruta. Tachanasti chanasti ruk. In the gulma, the rakta vidaha or the shonita vidaha is always there. As you saw in the case of the first patient, he was telling that he was having pancreatitis, but unbelievable. He was having gulma, and the cause of the gulma was the rakta pitta symptoms and the hepatic degeneration in him. Post hysterectomy. There is hardly anything you can do, because you can't again stick the uterus in her body. You can take care or assure that right now I am taking care of the symptomatology and the udavarta in you, but don't ever think that you will be permanently cured. You will need a touch up after every 2 to 3 years with some treatment, some udavartanashana treatment, the udavarta which is due to the removal of the uterus is always going to be there, since the nerves supplying the uterus are permanently cut down. The voltage comes to the end and hits back on the transformer. You can't stop the process. What you can do? Give a little correction after a short while, and you can maintain the patient with good exercise. That's all. You can never totally cure the patient if the hysterectomy is done already. At least don't boast and never promise anything to anybody after hysterectomy.
When you were saying when you were telling the story of Garuda, when you were explaining the mythology of Garuda.
Mythology of?
Garuda, the bird.
Garuda.
Yeah, Garuda.
Ah.
You were saying that if oral medication doesn't work, you have to give Basti. Yeah. Which type of Basti you have to give?
Basti essentially should contain the contents of the kashayas mentioned in the Rakthapitta. Only anti-CCP antibodies there, you can give the basti in with the kashaya given in the Rakthapitta. If the anti-DSDNA and the ANA is positive, then you have to think of the other disease also complicating in between, and that is Vata Rakta, and in that case the kashaya for the basti is to be selected from the Vata Rakta chapter, and in Vata Rakta he has given a stress statement that the tailas and the kashayas and the gritas already mentioned by me, they can be used in different forms. That means you can use the kashayas of the grita for basti, the kashaya of the taila for the basti, and you can add taila from outside, or you can use the pakva taila of that kashaya, and the decision is left to the utility doing person. But it works. I have cases totally anti-DSDNA, ANA, all going negative, and the people are living happy and healthy, unless and until they start consuming Ecosprin or some, for somebody says, if they start getting the Ecosprin, I am helpless, they can die, because they are producing the Rakta Dushti once more. I am not responsible for that. Anything else? Ah, yes, go on. Same complications are seen in
Shosha.
But the Shosha patient is totally different. You can just see and say that it is Shosha. Shosha is a Sandhigata Vikara. Rakthapitta is not a Sandhigata Vikara. Correct? The only thing, I forgot to stress that it is Mahagadam. Mahagadam. So, always remember, when they call it a Mahagada, you have to be very careful in treating the patients and the disease, and the treatment is not very simple. Correct? Choose the right medicines, go through the Bhava Prakasha, and you can win.
Sir, clinically, Tiryak Rakthapitta is treatable. Tiryak Rakthapitta is curable or incurable?
Is?
Curable or incurable? We can manage or no?
It should be curable. There is no problem to call it incurable.
But
if it is Ubhaya Margaga, it's very difficult to treat. if it is Ubhaya Margaga, because it never leaves you with many options. If it is Tiryaga, all right, you can do it.
Sir, you said Parpura, no sir. How we can manage that?
ITP. You can manage with the hepatic clearance, you increase the antitoxic treatment, you induce, and if at all needed after antitoxic treatment and the virechana and the hepatic clearance done, I have not required any medicine still to treat the purpura more than that. But if needed, the portion of the marrow which is lacking behind or if depressed can be selectively stimulated from outside by rasayana medicines. Easy. You have the rasayana medicines in the form of the palankasha, the dhataki, and that you get more from the haritakya divarga of the bhava prakasha, which is containing all the rasayanas. Just go through, you can do it.
If there is an injury inside the gut or anywhere else, and due to that the hematemesis or hemoptysis occur, is it considered under the Rakthapitha or not? Because it has a different samprapti.
No. That's not Rakthapitha.
Not a Rakthapitha.
That you have to take is it as Vrana or Visarpa. If associated with infective element, you have to take it as Visarpa. If not, you have to take it in the form of Vrana.
Kordush and Gandhir are mentioned in both Nidana and also Pathya of Rakthapitta.
Yes, yes, good question. In the Nidana, it has been told that it is Nidana when it is seven, it's consumed with the Amla Anupanam. And in the Pathya, when you are adding adequate deepana dravyas to the yusha, good amount of sneha, and then if you use it, it can be used to resuscitate temporarily. It's not a bruhana, it's a santarpana. It can give you supplement of protein loss on immediate basis, just like infusing the albumin. Okay? So albumin replacement, you can replace it with the yusha of these two, but if you want really to take the patient out of the disease, you need globulins to put in the patient and not albumins. Albumins are low molecular weight, they drain off quite easily through the body, and if you want the albumins to be held up in the body or retained, you have to increase the proportionate amount of globulins in his body, and for that, as I said, kebab, sharab aur shabab, in teenon ka jawab nahi hai. There you have to supply the direct proteins, correct? And Ayurveda is not stopping there only. Ayurveda, in the supplement of proteins, is not stopping there only. The world is now coming, in the last decade, somebody trying to talk about the first degree protein supplement. But the Ayurveda has already given it. Shosharsho grahani dosha vyadhi bhi karshitascha ye tesham kravyadamavsanam bruhana laghavo rasa. The kravyadamavsa rasa is specifically advocated for these people, Shosha Arsho Grahani Dosha Vyadhibhi Karshitas Chaye. So, not the only Kravyada Rasa, but the Kravyada Mausa Rasa. And I'm using it and getting the best results. In Kravyada, I'm using that baka, what you call it as? Baka, bagula. What in English? That you understand. For me it's baka. That white fish eater. I am using the mutton soup prepared out of baka's mutton, and that's giving wonderful results in ulcerative colitis, in Paitika Grahani, in the tropical sprue. I have almost 8 to 10 patients of Paitika Grahani totally recovered, and the key point in recovery was the Kravyada Mausa Rasa. If you input the first degree protein, as the protein increases, the enzyme system of the patient gets support, he starts digesting and comes out. No way to die with Grahani. Yes? You can try. Have you understood what is Kravyada? Yeah. The preparations prepared out of the animal who are fed only on meat. Only carnivorous animals. Because they can supply you the pre-digested protein. They can supply you the pre-digested protein. O jara samal ke baat kariyo. O eh hoy. Main baat kar raha pre-digested protein di. O hamare yahan adivasi ladke aaye hue the. Unhone suna ki ye maus khane wale janwaron कि मांस में बड़ी ताकत होती है. उन्होंने पार्टी की एक शेर को ही मार डाला और खा गए. अभी शेर बड़ा था, रख नहीं सकते थे. रखा तो पुलिस आके उठाई जाएगी कौन मारा करके. तो सारा का सारा 6-7 लोग मिलके खा गए. उस शेर के मांस खा कर के ये तगड़े होने से तो रहे, टॉक्सिसिटी आती योग होने से अजीर्ण होकर के ये बुद्ध के अनुयायी चल बसे. 6 में से 4 की डेथ हो गई. सो जरा संभल के मात्रावत आहार का महत्व है. पूरा शेर मारा तो शेर मार के खा जाओगे, ऐसा मत करना. Yes, but the Kravyada Mausa Ras, which is described in Ayurveda, is the first degree protein or the pre-digested protein, which is the most precious idea in the world of supplements and sold at a very high cost supplements. Anything else? Fish? No. If you are going to eat shark, then yes. Shark is first degree protein. Because it never eats anything algae or fungi. It directly eats fish. That is first degree protein. If not shark, don't think.
Excuse me. Yes. So can we notice any Rakthapithaa condition after blood transfusion? After blood transfusion, is there any chances of noticing Rakthapithaa lakshanas?
No. If it matches, then no problem. And if it is really necessary, if it is done for earning money by the doctor, then you may feel some overload symptoms. But not should not be essentially mimicking the Rakthapitta. Maybe some Gaurava and other things may be felt. But gone is the era of blood transfusion. Now the world is behind the Rakthavasti and other methods of increasing the blood. They are now well versed with the risks in the blood transfusion, which are more than benefits. You can easily do the same thing. You can give Rakthavasti, you can give Rakthapanam. That's a good idea. Safe. But transfusion is dangerous. Transfusion is deadly dangerous. And if you think that infusing something will increase your blood pressure, you are a big fool. मेरे को सब वही बोलते थे दुहाई दैट आयुर्वेदा हैज नॉट इंड्यूस्ड द ट्रांसफ्यूजन मेथड ऑफ मेडिसिन एडमिनिस्ट्रिंग एंड व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू डू इन द केसेस ऑफ एक्यूट डिप्लीशन इन माय अर्ली डेज आई वाज स्पीचलेस आई हैव नॉट थॉट But now, I think Ayurveda is the best because Ayurveda has advised the Ghritabhyanga, the Ghritamandanuvasanam. What does it mean? In the hypovolemia, you have to achieve the plasma expansion. And to expand the plasma, saline is the worst idea. And blood is still the worstest idea. To achieve the plasma expansion, you need something like dextran 70, dextran 90. And then what bad is the Ghrita? Which is a combo of 70 plus 90. At what rate you can infuse the dextran into the circulation? What is the bore of your needle? So small. When? As if you apply the Ghritamanda on the Sharira in Abhyanga, what is the surface area of the body? How many times the bore of a needle? And each centimeter, square centimeter of your surface area can transport 1 ml of ghee or the plasma expander for 10 minutes inside. For what the hell you need a blood transfusion or a transfusion system or that type of medicine delivery mechanism in this world? Your body is a very sensitive machine. As soon as it will sense the hypovolemia, it will try to absorb whatever expander comes to it. And if you can use the whole surface area of your body, which is many, many hundred times more than the bore of your needle, why should you need it? And what are you going to achieve by using that small bore needle for boring the person? And that's why Ayurveda has never given the IV therapy, but rather has given the plasma expanders and its absorption, and plus, no risk. No risk of overdose of plasma expansion, no risk of any electrolyte imbalance, no risk of sodium overdose causing cerebral edema and the patient dying in coma. The body reduces the speed of absorption as the volume is restored. When you see the ghee on the surface of the skin unabsorbed, you stop. That much plasma expansion is sufficient for the body. Why else you have to do the unnecessary plasma expansion or the water inside the circulatory system? वो म्यूनिसिपैलिटी का पाइपलाइन थोड़े है साले, पानी ज्यादा डालो तो साफ हो जाएगा. नाउ से हु इज मोर इफिशियंट एंड इफ एट ऑल टू हेल्प इट घृतमंडानुवासनम. The colonic surface and the surface of the rectum is directly absorbing the emulsified fat from the colon at the highest speed in the world. Why should you need a wasted mechanism like IV infusion? What are you going to achieve? Worst mechanism of delivering the medicine. लोग पूछते थे वो क्या हेड इंजुरी में क्या करोगे. हेड इंजुरी में इन्फ्यूजन इज इट द ओनली वे? नो सर, हिज कोलोनिक म्यूकोजा इज वर्किंग, यूज इट टू डिलीवर. It has direct contacts with the parasympathetic nervous system to stimulate the brain. Give him the dhuma. That's why in the head injury, Ayurveda has first rank treatment given dhumapanam snahikam. Whatever medicine you want to give the head injury patient, give him the dhuma of that medicine. And we have worked on it. Giving the dhuma in a head injury is 20 times more successful than infusion. Because when you put the dhuma inside the nose and the paranasal sinuses, it has direct emissaries which transport the medicine without any blood-brain barrier into the brain. And what more you want? If you infuse him, the medicine will be stopped at the blood-brain barrier, not transported directly in the required amount to the brain. And here you are transferring directly the medicine into the emissary veins and transporting it to brain within 0.6 seconds of delivery. Who is more effective? Why does you need the infusion system? Not at all. Not needed. Not needed. In the head injuries, the most dramatic role is played by the blood-brain barrier. To cross it, as soon as any accident happens, police shuts down the roads nearing by and nobody can enter, not the help even. How can you reach the brain? Is the direct idea dhumapanam. Burn the thing and put it in his respirator, it will be inside. Anybody? Anything else?
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Haha, bolo.
I was not getting the conclusion, sir, from that mom said about the blood transfusion. So if the donating is having the Rakthapitha, if they are donating that blood to other person, so there is no chance again that person getting Rakthapitha or what?
That is a problem of the receiver, not donor. As far as these allopathicians are concerned, for them, anything appearing red is blood. Whether it is dushta or not dushta, they don't understand anything. So, when I have some congestion in my panchakarma room and I want somebody to send for the blood donation, for the rakta mokshana, I simply send him to the blood bank. Ghi Gritabhanam deta hai, ek din rest deta hai, then tell him, go to the blood bank and donate the blood. Only say that, take the blood from the left median cubital vein. So that is the Ayurvedic way of rakta mokshana. You don't have any objection to that, if he has no objection.
I don't get, sir. I mean, sir, that Rakthapitha, if
transferring the Rakthapitha to the receiver.
Yes, the receiver can get the Rakthapitha, or no chance?
No.
Oh, okay, sir, thank you.
It will be infusing red water in his circulatory system. How much he can use and for what he is paying is his question, not our. Okay? But the Rakthapitha can't be transferred by blood transfusion. Yeah. Any drug resistant disease, medicine resistant disease, and you have to give the basti. It may be mukhapaka, it may be what she called as kya kahari? Wo kya psychological disorder jiska aapne jikr kiya? Schizophrenia or anything like that? Tuberculosis may bhi de sakte hai par. You have to be sure that the tuberculosis is medicine resistant. What you are hearing about the MDR TB is not resistant to the Ayurvedic medicines, because Ayurvedic medicines are not specific agents. We are using whole plant medicines, and in the ICMR copy of 1986, I read one article reading the Pippali, that 1/200 dilution of the water extract of Pippali is antimicrobiotic. Directly on contact. So, you hardly have anything to worry about. That's not MDR-TB, what you are getting in the current days is not the right version of medicine-resistant tuberculosis. It's just MDR-TB. Don't get worried. I have 6 to 7 cases of MDR-TB. Already cured, but my problem is that I don't charge in rupees. For MDR-TB I charge in dollars, because to keep one MDR-TB patient alive for 1 year, the bare minimum cost the world sends is more than $2 million. Am I wrong? Am I wrong? And if I am giving a cure, why shouldn't I charge that much only? Plus life in gift. What worth it is. So I charge in MDR TB, I charge in dollars, no transactions in rupees. Right or wrong, sir? How to be? The world has done a lot of value addition to Ayurveda. Don't underestimate. Just use your abilities. A lot of value addition has been done. Yes, sir?
Sir, I had a question about, you're mentioning for coagulation, the giving kshara.
Yeah.
And you said in the future we could develop it as an injection.
Yeah.
So my question was, when we give the medicines through the oral route, it like works through the agni and goes. So as an injection, would it still, like how does it differ? Because generally our medicines go through the...
Just I'll share my experience. I was worried whether the medicine I prepare works or not. So there was one patient, I did the Rakthamokshana from the left median cubital, put the whole blood in a bowl and when was to be discarded, suddenly something came in my mind and I asked my assistant, "Hey man, put in some of that medicine on the in the bowl and let's see what happens." He just added quarter spoon of the kshara to the bowl full of blood which was coagulated, moving like a jelly, kept it for 5 minutes. We tried to shake the bowl, it spilled out. It spilled out. Outside the body even, if this kshara is working at that potential, then my brain started working. If I can put quarter spoon in a bowl, why should not I purify it, make it into few milligrams? I can dilute it in sterile water and inject wherever I want. Since it's a water soluble product, with the least bore needle, I can do it anywhere in the body. I can do it anywhere in the body. And why should not I do it? Because there is nothing, no proteins, no fat, nothing in it, just water and salt. And it works. This is practical science. I am learning out of the practicals, which I did. In madness. Anything else?
Sir, in few people I have seen that they easily get skin bruises, like even a mild blow or pressure causes skin bruises. So,
yeah.
I was just thinking if there is any problem with their Rakthidharkala or is there any link between, like, is it related to Rakthapithaa or kind of this?
Skin is related to the Rasadhatu, that's not Rakta.
Not that bruises that.
Yeah?
That is skin bruises, cause that skin bruises that happens.
That is called as the mardava, mardava of the skin. That is something rasasarana. In the rasasara people, you get the symptoms like this. A little brush to the skin and it will go into bruises. And which is more common, when? Jo ladkiyan खूबसूरत बनने के लिए शताब्दी कल्प रोज का खाती है ना, रस वह स्रोत दे गेट द सप्लीमेंट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द शताब्दी कल्प. यू ऑब्जर्व देयर स्किन, उनको एक को कान के नीचे बजा के देखो कितनी देर तक गाल लाल रहता है, एंड दैट्स व्हाट यू आर कॉलिंग. हल्का भी ब्रूज होता है तो ज्यादा दिखता है, दैट इज सुकुमाराणाम, दैट इज त्वक सुकुमारता विच इज रिलेटेड टू द स्थाई रसा एंड नॉट कोष्ठस्थ रसा. एनीथिंग एल्स?
Relating the bruise, she told in the skin, you told it is not relating with the rakta, it is rasa. But I have a problem also bruising in my thigh region fully, and it is just occur not because of the pressure. I don't know because of what, sometimes it is coming and it is not feel pain and all like that. It is just appearance, but it will be come and it will be go by it itself. But when I check the lab, it is my what is that? Clotting blood of myself, it is below the normal. So it is related to the rakta, right, sir?
What is low?
Clotting blood.
Clotting time. Clotting time blood. Is less.
Yes.
Should not be related with the rasa.
With the rakta.
Should not be related with the rakta. How much is your platelet count? Because all the clotting factors that were given to you are not working on the corpuscular matter. If it is working on corpuscular matter like that platelets, then it's a condition related with the rakta dhatu, otherwise not. Otherwise you have to take the blood or the rakta, and the internal balance of the clotting factors is somewhere at fault and you have to correct it.